Hello. Welcome to beautiful Bondi Beach, and a special welcome to Bondi Surf Club, the first in Australia. The name Bondi Beach is known worldwide and immediately evokes a vision in people's minds of blue water, white sand, and the bronzed Bondi lifesaver.
Famous around the world, it's been called the playground of the Pacific, and the fact that so many people come here to enjoy the sun and the surf only adds to the importance of Bondi's best, those who wear the distinctive blue and white with the pride that comes with a distinguished history. They not only add to the colour of Bondi, but also to its popularity as a safe beach from which to swim and surf. But it hasn't always been a centre of sun and fun. Once part of a private land grant, what Captain Cook first sighted from his ship Endeavour on Sunday the 6th of May 1770, and later became known as Bondi Bay, was closed to the general public until 1855. Then, swimming, even in daylight hours, was banned under the Police Offences Act, and when that rule was eventually relaxed, visitors to Bondi Beach had to wear one-piece bathing costumes, which covered from neck to knee, for the sake of decency. But by the 1950s, that had given way to the two-piece costume. And then came the sensation known as the bikini.
It was an itsy-bitsy, teeny-weeny, yellow polka-dot bikini that she wore for the first time today.
Nowadays, the southern end of Bondi is more famous as a spot where sunseekers can go topless. But throughout all the years of change, the famous Bondi Surf Club has been a constant feature since its formation in 1906. Among the first people rescued from the Bondi surf was a young boy, later to become internationally famous himself as Australia's pioneer aviator, Sir Charles Kingsford Smith. Perhaps the most successful organised event at Bondi was the Royal Command Surf Carnival in 1954. More than 12,000 spectators joined Her Majesty the Queen and His Royal Highness the Duke of Edinburgh in a day of typical Bondi sunshine, surf and action.
Lifesavers are going to show the Queen and the Duke what they can do, and what the Pacific surf can do to them. Right. All set. Here we go. Wonder that the Queen stayed on of Bondi long beyond her scheduled time.
Even that, however, must count second to the heroic history of the Bondi Surf Club, to the brilliance and bravery demonstrated when it really mattered. Black Sunday, 1938.
Bondi Beach, early in February in the year 1938. A summer Sunday when Bondi saw a disaster unparalleled in the history of Australia's most famous beach. Suddenly, and without any warning on that day, a series of freak waves thundered into Bondi, sweeping hundreds of panic-stricken surfers out to sea. It led to the biggest mass rescue ever seen on a Sydney beach, And for men like Carl Jeppesen and Basil McDonald, who took part in that rescue, 40 years has done little to erase the memory of what happened.
A couple of big waves, fairly big, I suppose about 6 or 8 feet waves roll in. They're a little bit bigger than ones that had been before, and they washed a few people from the bank into a side channel that was alongside them. Our patrol on the beach was on its way to get them, and then in rolled about 3 or 4 more bigger waves. They rolled in so quickly that normally a wave comes in and recedes, and in this case, there was no time for recession. When the 3 or 4 big waves rolled in, they receded, or the water from them receded in such a volume that it swept over the bank and swept the people on the bank into the channel, deep channel on the side.
So those people didn't really have a chance to get up?
They didn't have a chance at all.
What went against the rescue on that day, of course, the public, in their endeavour to help, they raced through and grabbed the lines, in addition to the lifesavers who were on the lines at the time, and pulled them in. And they're pulling them in all kinds of directions, yeah. You see. And naturally enough, they knotted. And this impeded quite a few rescues.
An estimated 30,000 people were on Bondi Beach that day, and when the big waves hit, the surf was crowded with swimmers. Miraculously, most of them survived, but before it was over, 5 people had drowned and scores more were brought back from the brink of death after being dragged unconscious from the water. The death toll should have been higher, much higher, but on Black Sunday, according to Carl Jeppesen, fate took a hand in things.
Usually on a Sunday afternoon about that time, 3 o'clock, we have our normal competition races amongst our members. But on some Sundays, when the beach is crowded as it was that day, and the members are required for other duties, and the surf boat, the only surf boat we had, could be required, rather than use it, we used to declare our race off. Luckily that morning when I was asked about the race, I said, yes, we'd have it. It was only a sort of luck decision, it could have gone either way. But that resulted in the fact that at that time at 3 o'clock, we had 60 members of our club on the beach, ready for us to enter this race. We had 2 patrols on, one just coming off, one going away, so we had a double strength patrol. And as I said before, if fate had decided to run, have a calamity like that at Bondi Beach, it couldn't have given us a better opportunity of being prepared for it. It was really amazing. It's a decision that I've always been happy I made, because I believe the loss of life in there would have been incredible, because to get members from the club down in time to help would have been a bit late by the time we got them and assembled them on the beach to help us. It was so sudden and went with so much rapidity that we didn't know.
50 years on, that day is marked by a small, inconspicuously placed certificate at the club. The original surf life-saving concept of better-class swimmers helping the less proficient survives to this day. The Surf Life-Saving Organisation started here at Bondi and has spread throughout Australia and around the world. The famous reel and line was invented here at the Bondi Surf Club. The original model was made from hairpins and a cotton reel. And the surf reel now features in the regular competitions between surf life-saving clubs. The traditional surf boats, and more recently the rubber duckies, which are so much faster, also feature in competition, which sharpens the skills of the surf lifesavers. And Bondi has had many successes in both individual and team events. Australia's beaches have never been safer. Lifesavers with boards, tubes and surf skis save many lives in the seas off Australian beaches. They are supported by an expanding fleet of helicopters, powered inflatable craft, and jet rescue boats. These modern machines are linked to a sophisticated radio communications network, but more importantly, backed by the traditional enthusiasm and dedication of Australia's 100,000 volunteer lifesavers, whose march started here at Bondi and looks certain to continue as long as the surf keeps pounding the shore.